Hello, good morning children. Today we are going to start lecture number 2 of chapter 1. First we discuss about the chapter number 1 and lecture 1. Not for the lecture number 2, but we discuss here now about lecture number 1. What we have already discussed or studied in Lecture 1. So, topics which were studied in lecture number 1, then is economic activity, then non-economic activity, difference between economic and non-economic. So, what is objective of economic and what is objective of non-economic activity? So motive is to get economic benefit and motive is to social service, human service, and that means social welfare services. Then expectations in economic activity is the profit, salary, fees, etc. And in non-economic activity is to service to country and social service. And types of economic activity like business, profession and employment. And in non-economic activities, no type of that. Then in economic activity, there remain risk and uncertainty. And in non-economic activity, there is no risk and uncertainty. Then we studied about the types of economic activity in detail. First type is business. What is business? Business means an illegal economic activity with the motive of profit. Then we studied about characteristics, objective of profit, exchange of goods and service, then risk and uncertainty, creation of goods, continuance of activity, requirement of money and economic activity. Total 7 characteristics of business. First, objective of profit. Second, exchange of goods and service. In first characteristics, important line is that profit is a barometer of business. Third characteristics, risk and uncertainty. Fourth, creation of utility. In this point, important point is creation of utility takes place in 3 ways: form, place and time. Then continuance of activity. Then requirement of profit. Money is required from the beginning to the end of the business. And last one is economic activity. And now, in today's lecture, we are going to start objective of business. But before that, I told you which topics we learn today. Lecture 2. Today's topic, first, objective of business. 2 types of objective: economic objectives and social objective. In economic objective, there are 3 types: profit, maximization of wealth, and other objective. And second type of objective, social. In that, first objective of social responsibility, then objective to provide employment opportunities, then objective to provide quality goods and service, and to adopt fair trade practice and other objectives. Then we will discuss about business risk. There is also 2 type of business risk: natural risk and man-made risk. And then last topic of today's lecture is causes of business risk. So total 3 topics we study today. First, objective of business. Second, business risk. And the third one is causes of business risk. So we are going to start. So objectives of business. Though the primary objective of business is making profit more than one objective are accepted due to awareness among customer, restriction of state and changing condition. The objective of business can be divided into two parts. First one is economic and the second one is social. Before that, you underline this point, primary objective of business. What is primary objective of business? That is making profit. And now we start economic objective. First, profit. Since a business is an economic activity, a reasonable return on employee capital must be obtained. What is employee capital? You studied in accounting. Sorry, you will study in accounting. This return is profit. When any businessman, business owner invests some money or asset and he want to some return from that, that is called profit. Its reason is profit, and that reason is useful for return to employed capital. That is called profit. So since a business is an economic activity, a reasonable return on employed capital must be obtained. This return is profit. So, something earned with something investment. That is profit. To earn profit is essential not only for the existence of the business but also for the growth of business. Profit is a motivating force, barometer of efficiency and lifeblood of business. Please underline, profit is essential not only for the existence but also for the growth of business. In these days, the concept of reasonable profit is accepted instead of maximum profit. Now, current time, most of the reasonable profit concept is accepted, not a maximum profit. By earning reasonable profit, a business unit gets acknowledgement in the society along with the earning fair profit. A business unit can be acknowledged by the society and can survive in the competition by earning fair profit. If business want to survive in the competition, in today's competition, then business can accept a reasonable profit concept instead of maximum profit. Because if business accept the maximum profit concept, then he cannot survive in today's competition. So business unit gets the concept of reasonable profit and acknowledgement in the society along with their earning fair profit and can survive the competition. So second economic objective, that is maximization of wealth. What is maximization of wealth? One type of growth of our business. The objective of a profit is a short-term concept related with annual income of business. Yes, profit is calculated every year, and profit is a short term, not a long term. But maximization of wealth is a long term objective. The project which increase the wealth of business at a long run are accepted. In a circumstance like depression, business has to give up the objective of profit. Sometimes the business is not running well, and then that type of situation or circumstance, businesses give up the objective of profit and is making a loss. At that time, long-term objective is helping, that is maximization of wealth. That's why objective of maximization of wealth is related with the economic benefit of the owner of the business. And the third economic objective, that is other economic objectives. In this point, most of the other economic objectives are covered. That is growth of business, expansion of market, best possible utilization of resources, application of modern technology, etc. Please, children, ignore the external voice and please don't lose your concentration, because in this situation we can't stop the external voice. Still, I try my best, but you please support me and don't lose your concentration, okay? Now, second type of objective is a social objective. Social objective of business. I think you all remember in starting of this chapter, I was told you business is running through people's money, society's money. And that's why business has a responsibility for the public. In my first lecture of your standard, I was giving you some introduction of chapter number 11. Got it? Remember all? At that time, I told you about some social responsibilities of business. And now here point is related that the social objective of business. So social objectives are given a priority by business for the benefit of society. The existence of business not possible without society. Because if we all are not buying that product, then how can the business run? Right? So without us, not possible existence of business. Business is due to society. Therefore, the importance of the objective other than profit is accepted. Social objectives are given below. First, objective of social responsibility. It has become necessary for the business to be aware of the interest of the different groups of society. Because of consumer awareness, state's restriction, consumer education, association. Please underline consumer awareness, state restriction, consumer's education and consumer association. Different interest group or classes of society such as owner, employee, customer, creditor, government, etc. are associated with business unit, and these different groups have different interest with the business. They all are included in society. It is necessary to take care of interest of these different groups. The business has to abide by maintenance of environment, Employees Welfare Act, Factory Act, Consumer Protection Act, etc. In detail about this, we will study in chapter number 11. Then, second point, provide employment opportunity. Most of the people are unemployed in our country, and ratio of unemployment is increasing day by day. So some business units are established with the special objective to create a new opportunities of employment, like khadi, cottage industries, and those industries which provide an employment opportunity. Preference is given to the establishment of business unit in backward areas, special for the people of backward areas to provide employment to unemployed people, because public or people of backward areas are uneducated, and that's why they all are unemployed. Next topic is the third objective, to provide quality goods and service. Any business provides some product, right? First they produce and then provide to society. But it should be goods and service is provided to the quality with the good quality, not in quantity. Quantities also matter, but quality is more of effective than quantity. So it is the objective to provide quality goods and service in order to make them easily available to the people of Sioux City so they can satisfy their needs. And the units manufacturing spices used in cooking, cold drinks, foods have to maintain the standards of quality. Business unit having social objective are committed to provide goods and services at fair price. That for example, delivery of goods at home, after sale service, installation of goods, etc. Current example I give. Current season for the wheat and rice and other spices, we all collect for all year, right? So when we purchase a wheat or rice, so at that time, a man who came our home and totally the goods of delivery goods and installation of goods service provide to us. So that is extra service provided by the man. So it is satisfied service objectives to provide quality goods and service and other related service. Then fourth number, objective to adopt fair trade practices. What? Objective to adopt fair trade practices. Black marketing of product. That means, what is black marketing? A product sell at higher price in market. Product A, normal price of that product is 20, but for 2 to 3 months, seller store this that product, and after 2 to 3 months, that product sell at higher price, because in 2 to 3 months scarcity of that product is rise, right? Rise of scarcity, and then when people need that product, at that time that seller sell this product at higher price. That is called black marketing. Accumulation of goods, misleading advertisement, etc. are unfair practices in business. Artificial scarcity of inflation essential goods must not be created. Business unit must adopt the objective of fair trade practices for the welfare of customer and society. I give some new examples, like any beauty cream, you can take advertisement in TV, like Fair and Lovely cream, right? It's just an example. You can take any beauty cream, any of company. Okay, in TV advertisement, we see the in 6 days, 7 days, your skin is fair and white, but in actual, no. Not a little effect on your face. So that is misleading advertisement. It is misguided to public. So that is not fair trade practices, right? Then fifth objective, other objectives. Other social objectives are establish special identity in society, to conduct research work in field of production, helpful in economic development of nation, and cooperate with the government for the same. Then provide various incentives to the employee and execute welfare scheme for them. So here, five objectives of social objective of business objective. So main topic is that is here is business objective. Two types of that. First is economic objective, and second one is the social objective. Economic objective includes profit, maximization of wealth, and other economic objective. Then social objective include objective of social responsibilities, objective to provide employment opportunity, objective to provide quality goods and service, then objective to adopt fair trade practices, then other objectives. Other objective includes establish special identity, conduct research, work in field of production, helpful in economic development of nation and cooperate with the government, then provide various incentives to the employee and execute welfare scheme for them. Now we are start the business risk. Next topic, that is business risk. There is an uncertainty of profit or risk of loss in the business. The uncertain events of the future affect the profit. Thus, it can be said that profit is a reward against. Some uncertain events of the future affect our profit of business. That's why we can say that our business profit is a reward against the business risk. There are two type of risk in business. First one is natural risk and second is man-made risk. So what is natural risk? Like natural calamities, earthquake, flood, drought, etc. are the natural risk. Hinder the growth of the business and destroy or damage all the assets of the business. So the business has no control over a natural risk. Out of two types of risk, natural risk is has no control under the business. Business has no control over natural risk. Then second is man-made risk. Man-made risk under the development of the business, and as a result, business has to suffer the loss. These risks are strike of employee, change in technology, change in taste, demand of customer, political instability, risk of competition in market, and so on. So many types of risk, including in the man-made risk. Strike of employee, change in technology, change in taste, current fashion, then demand of customers, political instability. So two types of business risk and some causes of business risk. Reason of business risk. Other word used for this reason. So in examination question is asked like write the causes of business risk or write a reason of business risk. So you have to write this point. First one is changing technology. Changes are necessary in production method due to invention in technology. Day by day new technology will come in and business install that technology. So new technology is to be adopted to produce high quality goods because new technical machineries is save time and money both and produce more compared to first. New machineries have to be installed for the replacement of old machineries. Then second, threat of substitute product. The customer may turn to substitute product due to change in technology. For example, ball pen in the place of fountain pen. And a normal example, we can take like, you drink coffee instead of or in place of tea. So coffee is a substitute of tea, right? Vessel of steel in a place of copper and brass, television in place of radio. These all are example of substitute product. And the third point is competition. Most important reason of business risks, that is competition. Competition increases the business risk, which directly affects the business profit. The sale price of product is to be reduced and advertisement expense are to be incurred by business unit. To maintain its position in market and to face competition, thus profit gets reduce. Fourth, legislation. Legislation. Government formulates the law regarding pollution, customers, worker, industries, etc. But these law causes risk for the business, like Minimum Wages Act and Factory Act. They hinder the business in decision making. Some government formulates law, related provisions, rules, which all are sometimes hinder the business and decision making. Like minimum wages, decided in Minimum Wages Act. So that is interfere in business decision making. So this one is also causes for of business risk. Then fifth is uncertainty of demand. Uncertainty of demand for the product create the risk for the business. Changes in customers' income. For example, now we use a higher quality product, but suddenly due to this lockdown, our salary, our income is decreased. So now we change our demand and we need some necessary goods, not our luxurious goods. So demand of these luxurious goods is decreasing. So that is the effect of the reason the customer's income decreases. Then taste of customer, product price, inflation, etc. create uncertainty for the demand, which affect the profit of business. Because demand of particular product is decreased, then also the profit of our business is decreased. Then physical risk. Damage to the asset which are utilized in business create physical risk. Machinery which we used for produce our product is damaged. So it is also risk for our business. Non-functioning of machinery and equipments, damages in transit of goods create physical risk. So here we studied total six type of causes, causes for business risk. First is change in technology. Second, threat of substitute product. Third, competition. Fourth, legislation. Fifth, uncertainty of demand. And sixth, physical risk. You should write this point in your fair note, not in detail, only head points. And the new topic and second type is profession. We will study in next lecture. Here we discuss about some important questions from the exercise. So question in detail. First question, what is business, and state the objective of business. Then characteristics of business, business risk and causes of business risk. These three questions you learn in your fair note, and definition of business, meaning of business, you write in your fair note. But head points questions like objectives, risk, then characteristics, you write only the head point in your book, and detailed information you read at least one or two times, not necessary to write. Okay, here we complete today's lecture. Goodbye everyone, and from the next lecture we start the next topic, profession. Okay, goodbye.